Actually, Allah has so many names and attributes that describe Him, like the merciful, the forgiving. But why do Muslims use more frequently the word Allah more than any other word? It's because you can have a merciful son and a forgiving wife. But when a Muslim wants to communicate with another person and he wants him to understand that he means God, then he needs to say Allah, the one and only God.
The all-merciful, the beneficent, the savior, the knower of all, the hearer of all, and the seer of all, the judge and the just, the all-aware, the magnificent, the forgiver, the highest, the greatest, the preserver, the mighty, the generous one, the watchful one, the responder to prayer, the perfectly wise, the loving one, the majestic one, the resurrector, the truth, the possessor of all strength, the ever-living one, and the self-existing one, the all-powerful, the supreme one, the patient one, and the guide to repentance. What is the purpose of life? Is it to enjoy the pleasures of this world? To eat and drink and reproduce? The purpose of life is one of the most fundamental questions, but still most people are unable to answer.
If we meet someone in a hotel and ask him, "What is the purpose of your existence in this hotel?" he should give us an answer. He may say, "Well, I am here because I have a booking, or I came to meet some people who are staying in this hotel, or I came to eat in a restaurant." But if he says, "Huh? I don't know what I'm doing here," then this person is probably lost and he needs guidance. What if we ask ourselves, "What are we doing here on planet Earth?" Those who don't know the answer, those who do not know the purpose of their life, need guidance.
Allah said in the Quran, "I have not created the jinn and humankind except that they should worship me." If we think about all the gifts given to us, our eyes, how can we thank the Creator for the gift of vision? Our ears, how can we thank Him for the gift of hearing? Did we ever think about our kidneys and the hundreds of simultaneous chemical operations that happen in them to purify our bodies from fatal toxins? Did we ever think about our brains and the amount of information that it is acquiring and retrieving in no time? Did we ever think about our hearts that keep on beating nonstop for a lifetime? Add to them the gifts of having children and wealth and so many more bounties. The Quran challenges man to count the bounties of Allah, which are infinite and uncountable.
"And He gives you of all that you ask Him, and if you count Allah's favors, you will not be able to number them. Surely man is very unjust, very ungrateful."
Allah is the one worthy of all thanks, all praise, and all worship. The purpose of life is to submit and be in a continuous state of worship.
Some people may think, "Come on, give me a break. How can I worship continuously? I need some time to sleep, I need some time to eat, I need some time to work and make some money." And explaining this leads us to talk about the concept of worship in Islam, because it's different from the concept of worship in any other religion. In any religion, to worship is to pray, fast. These are called rituals, a very small part of the worship in Islam. In Islam, to worship is to do anything that is lawful with good intentions.